Ken Robinson's talk on how schools can kill creativity is the number one TED talk for good reason.
My contention is that creativity now is as important in education as literacy.
And it certainly inspired the whole community of St Saviour's Primary School in Paddington. Every year for the last 3 years, a fantastic bunch of parents, teachers, outside creatives and the local community have come together to give their children a school day like no other. An adrenaline shot of creativity, where they can choose from up to 20 thinking and doing creative activities from right across the STEAM spectrum. That's science, technology, engineering, arts, and maths. We were delighted this year when Ford sponsored an activity to build an electric car that's going to be raced later in the year at the world-famous Goodwood Racetrack. Last year, in another activity, every one of the 240 5 to 11-year-olds in the school were taught to write their first program on a Raspberry Pi computer in Scratch to make a Lego robot crocodile bite their finger. It featured in Wired and a BBC documentary, as well as on global Al Jazeera news bulletins and the front pages of two Brazilian newspapers. We now have a code club every week in the school and even had a trip to Sony's factory in Wales where they make them. We had great support this year from Google, who've given 15,000 Raspberry Pis to UK schools, and we even had some of their team along to help with Coder Corner this year. We're now trying to get funding and sponsorship so that we can give every school in the UK a special day of creativity, like the one we've had for 3 years now. Now, when we saw Kane's arcade film, we just had to include it as an activity in our day, which, as luck would have it, this year was the day before Global Cardboard Challenge Day.
Hello, my name's Jesse.
And I'm Sam.
We really loved Kim's film and we were really excited when our dad said it was going to be an activity on our special day.
At the start of the day, an inventor called Darcy showed us a great big robot game he'd made out of cardboard. He and a few parents, including my friend Gabriel's dad, spent the rest of the day helping us all make things out of cardboard.
Our local IKEA gave us loads of old cardboard, and we had lots of really cool make-do kits to help us fix things together.
The children made lots and lots of cool things, like games, animals, and all sorts of random things.
We then had a real surprise when the BBC phoned up in the afternoon and said that they wanted us to go to their studio in Manchester to be on their breakfast TV programme the next morning.
Now, what would you create with the cardboard boxes, a roll of tape and some cable ties? Lots of suggestions, maybe a robot, a den, perhaps a toy car.
Yes, last year a 9-year-old boy from Los Angeles became an internet hit when he created an entire cardboard arcade complete with ticket dispensers and miniature football. You might remember it.
Mm-hmm. Inspired by Kane Monroe's creativity, today is Global Cardboard Challenge Day.
So joining us now, look at that, furiously rearranging the little things they've been building. We saw those last-minute adjustments, is Nick Corston, who's organiser of London's Cardboard Challenge, along with competitors Jesse and Andreas.
Morning,
you can
all.
See over
Morning.
Here.
Yes.
And over my side, we have Marina and Samara and Mum Sarah. Very good morning.
Good morning.
Morning, all. You've been having great fun. These are just a few examples of what you've made this morning. Do you want to take me through? Tell me what this is. Show everybody at home and tell me what this is.
This is a monster's pet.
Yeah.
I didn't really have time to fit on the tail, which is here.
Yeah. Turn it around, he's got eyes. Is it a boy or a girl pet?
It's a boy.
And he's got a mouth.
His eyes can move singly. Not really, we couldn't draw it on a nose.
Oh, well, it's got a sort of mouth.
That's a work in progress, that one, midway through. Yeah. Jesse, have you been building anything?
Yes, I've been building this, so it's an army game. So these are two blockers and that's a goalie, so you have three chances. Try and score a goal. And every time you score a goal, you get 1 point and you get another ball.
Does someone control the goalkeeper?
No.
No, so you just get a free shot, effectively. Yeah. Very good.
What about you two? What have you been doing?
We've been making a castle.
And this
we made
is the t-
and this is the door, and then the handle, and then it's only got one window because at the back all the people don't want other they think that they should only look out of things because they're not very nice people, so they have to think that they should look out of things rather than people looking in.
Oh, sorry, who's not nice people? The people who live in there?
Yeah.
Mm. Why are they not nice?
They wanted to. They wasted their money on something.
On a castle.
Oh, really? When there are so many different.
They don't know how. They don't think before they do anything.
Oh my goodness! There's a moral in the story and everything. This is.
You've really thought that one through.
A few, not long to make this, and this what's really striking about all of the things that you've made and the stories that you tell is there is just so much creativity out there that perhaps children, you know, we should just be giving them boxes rather than other things. What do you think, Nick?
I absolutely agree. I think if this is one day to put the smartphones down, put the computers and the games consoles away just for one day and give the child a cardboard box, a piece of sticky tape, a little tie wrap, and let them go and create. I mean, the children have got a story behind everything, and you can look at a box and think, when are they going to finish it? It's finished, it's in their head. And I think it's about imagination. And Albert Einstein, I think, said years ago, imagination will take you anywhere. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're proving today, you know, and every child can have a lot of fun with nothing.
But you've got a choice. You can play with cardboard or you can watch telly. What would you do?
Play with cardboard.
Yeah.
Really? What about you?
Play with cardboard. Definitely play with cardboard.
Really?
Cardboard.
You guys would probably enjoy this.
Good luck with the rest of the day.
I sort of believe you with the TV cardboard thing. Yeah, good and bad castles. Thank you.
Woodford, I'm the head teacher of this great school, and we're very proud of this very special day. It's our third year now, and we really just turn the school over to the children. And there is a lot of work that goes behind it. It's not just like somebody comes in with a glue gun or a ukulele or whatever it happens to be. And we're really pleased that we've got three parents who have been really super and helping us. And the children are, because they're allowed to do what they want to do, but they don't do it in any other way other than I'm having fun. There's no trouble, children don't argue, because they know that they're very safe in this environment. And you get to talk to different children, and you talk to them in a different way than you would do, you know, when I'm doing an assembly for 240 children. You have to be a different person than you can be today. So, but they're a bit like building the car behind us. That teacher usually teaches year six. Well, he's working with children from nursery, reception, because they all want to come in and have a go at doing something. But then there's a parent who's become involved with that over there, and he's a reception parent, but he's now working with different parents who are further up the school. So that meeting of minds of people who are interested in doing things. And sometimes you get people who say, oh, I'm not very artistic, I don't want to do that. And you say, oh, well, come in and make the tea, come in and help clear up. And then they go, oh, actually, I could do that. And you get people, but sometimes you get people who are didn't have a very good experience at school themselves. So they prefer to drop their children at the gate and they don't want them to come in. They don't want to come in, it's like, oh, no, it's too horrible. But now they'll come in and they'll say, oh, well, I'll come in to do that. I'll come in to do that. And the people, you know, who would think, oh, I'll come in and cut up milk cartons all day. And everyone's very happy that they've tightened up milk cartons all day. So it's quite nice. It just, and people then, you know, you get to talk to parents in the way that you wouldn't normally talk to them, or you wouldn't interact with them in the same way.
So we've, if you like, done this for 3 years now. We'd like to think we've proved the concept. And having done all the hard work, we can now roll it out. And what we're looking to do is get 10 pilot schools who can do what we've done here themselves with a little bit of help and encouragement and a little bit of funding maybe, prove that it can be rolled out and then maybe roll it out as a national initiative with appropriate financial support and help.
I would recommend it because but you just have to be brave enough to do it. Now, if you're in a school, we're in a school where the children, there's an expectation that you will behave and you will enjoy yourself and you will learn and you won't disturb other people and you will do your homework and you will respect other people and have learned good manners and all that sort of stuff.